God, what could it be? What would be a good comparison? I remember watching Naruto on YouTube. And to watch it, what I would do is I would start an episode downloading, because back then you could download a whole episode of something on YouTube and it wouldn't, like, pause the buffer or whatever. I'd start an episode downloading, go, like, do something for half an hour, and then once that one was done, I would start another episode downloading, and while I was watching the first one, the second one would get about, I don't know, 75% done, and then as I was watching the second one, it would finish. Like, it was terrible. Napster, like, that was, like, yeah, Napster. LimeWire was what I always used back in my days of high school-related roguery. And then there was, God, what was fucking Kazaa, I think, was the other one. That was the early days of the internet, before, like, if you wanted to watch anime, you just go to, like, fucking Crunchyroll or whatever and watch whatever the hell you want. It's fucking dark times. And because, like, that's another thing, is, like, growing up, you know, never had cable internet, or not cable internet, like, cable TV, so, like, stuff like Naruto and whatnot, watching that was, like, just completely new. Like, what is this anime? I've never heard of, what is anime? Because, like, up to that point, the only animes I'd ever seen was, like, God, what did we have? Like, in local channels, we'd get, like, Sailor Moon, maybe, like, some Dragon Ball Z. For a while, we had The Vision of Escaflowne, which is amazing. And it's just, like, fucking ridiculous. Oh, man, when I discovered emulators, I never realized how many games I had missed growing up until I figured out, like, emulators. Like, on the Super Nintendo side in particular, like, I didn't play any of the Super Nintendo era Final Fantasy games until, like, mid-2000s and stuff. I did all that stuff when I was in high school. It was fucking ridiculous. And now I own, like, basically, I think I own every Final Fantasy except for 13, too. Oh, fucking sniper rifle, thank you. Like, everything took forever. I remember downloading a demo for this game called Realms, R-E-L-M-Z. It was like an old school PC dungeon crawler type thing. And, like, I remember having to, like, let downloads run overnight, and of course it killed your phone line, and, oh, it was fucking terrible. And if anybody picked up the phone, it would, like, destroy your download, and all that time would be lost, and, yeah, dark times. I do not miss the days of 56K. Yeah, we couldn't afford a second line. We eventually got this, like, program thing that you could run called Callwave, and it was basically like an answering machine that would intercept phone calls while you were online. It was weird. It was, I don't know, like, the internet side of things sucked, but back then there really wasn't much internet like there is now. As for phone lines, I personally think cell phones are a blight upon society. The only reason I have one is so that my wife has a way to contact me in emergency situations. I literally do not use it for anything. I mean, like, I'll look at Reddit while I'm using the bathroom or whatever, but I am not a cell phone person, whereas, conversely, my wife was raised with them, essentially. Like, she had one as soon as they became a thing, and, like, she was in high school and she had, like, a pager and shit. It's just, like, completely different. And, oh, there's, like, a night vision sight on this thing. Nice. So, like, she is on her cell phone, like, all day, 24/7, and I basically just use mine to browse Reddit when I get bored. And it's thermal detection, or maybe the game's just weak. Oh. I like this gun. I like this gun a lot. I don't like this fence intercepting my bullets. Seriously, guy? I mean, it's intercepting their bullets too, I guess. But their bullets are more accurate than mine. A cell phone on your 17th birthday. I didn't get a cell phone until I was 27. And I am 31 now. For reference, I am a fucking crunchy grognard motherfucker. No, my wife's actually 10 years older than I am. Holy man. She was just... I was raised as a poor kid in a cornfield, and she was, like, basically the opposite of that. Organization. What are you talking about? Fucking Nokias. I was bulletproof. Holding them together. When I left,
they fell apart. That's not what I heard.
What did you hear?
Well, let's just say my sources didn't think too highly of you.
Oh, really?
They said you were kind of lazy and belligerent the whole time you were there.
Who are you gonna trust? I'm telling you, they were morons.
I'm gonna grenade these guys.
They were.
I hope they all rot.
What's up, guys? I like this grenade launcher a lot. It's pretty wonderful. What? Oh, electric fence. Nice. Yeah, like, I'm not saying that, like, cell phones are useless. Like, they, as you say, they very much, like, I use mine when I'm at work, I guess. I listen to music on it and, like, podcasts. And like, yes, they are very useful in a lot of ways, but I think that people are a little bit too obsessed with them in a lot of ways. But then I say this as somebody that's on a computer for, like, I say this as somebody that's on a computer for, like, literally 10 plus hours a day. So, it's the way of things. I have, like, I have enough hit points. That's all that matters to me. Oh, wonderful. Our quick save is our hit points. Come on. There we go. Fucking Klaus taking all the cigarettes. Alright, come on, RNGesus, favor my fucking harpoon gun. Thank you, RNGesus. What? Shit, there's one behind me? What? Oh my god, seriously? Sneaky run!
Over there.
It's somebody over there. Where did this harpoon erupt into your face from? I'm gonna keep shooting you in the knee, buddy. I got 9 more of these things. Guy, come on now. Dude! It's like impervious. Shit. He had like 5 harpoons in him. That was a steel knee. No kidding. Hell. This guy over peeing in the corner or something. But yeah, like, I suppose me saying that cell phones are a blight on society is probably a bit of hyperbole. But at the same time, I think a lot of, like I said, I think a lot of people are maybe on them a little bit more than they ought be. Nothing wrong with that, Mel. I mean, admittedly, I don't watch TV, so. We are a trainee.
Once you reach the chateau, you will have to act quickly. The first challenge is to locate the list. The greater challenge will be to deliver it to command. Needless to say, subtlety is advisable.
Damn it.
The odds against you are already overwhelming enough without you drawing undue attention to yourself.
All right. Acid gas, good joke, game. Let's see, grenade launcher, harpoon gun, and what's our... Let's see, I'm tempted to take the SVD, honestly. My problem is finding ammo for it, but it's gonna be easier, like, this is something that's gonna be harder to find in the mission, I think, than... an SMG or whatever. Codebreaker, sunglasses, and... I'm gonna actually take the camera disablers. And the fuzzy slippers. Less is more my ass, that's why I have a grenade launcher. I took the grenade launcher instead of the missile launcher. That's my less is more. No cell phone, grr, talkie box is bad. I mean, if you wanna dick around on your cell phone and watch TV all day, that's entirely on you. Like, I don't give a shit. I'm just gonna think less of people that do that. Not in any meaningful way, but... Like, there's like, you know, hobbies you could be doing. And multitask. Like, if you want to watch TV, fine, watch TV. But, like, while you're watching TV, do something else. Like, for example, I watch YouTube videos a lot. But, like, I'm typically got them in the background while I'm, like, I don't know, painting miniatures or whatever. Programming, etc., etc. Oh, I just realized they healed me and shit. Nice. I don't know how that works, but I'll take it. But I'm not gonna say that, like, people that, like, watch TV as, like, a hobby or a pastime, like, oh, you're a terrible person. I'm just gonna lightly judge. Just as I'm sure, like I said, people will judge me because I'm on a computer 10 hours a day. Like, that's bad in its own way. And I cannot fuck with these, alas. Yeah, exactly, Marvel, exactly. Like, everybody's gonna look at stuff differently. Like, damn kids in their video games, for example. You know? I'm sitting here for 4 hours playing video games for people on the internet. He's not alright, neither are you! But this is my way of unwinding after, you know, a week. And it's nice. Camera.
Stay where you are.
No. I appreciate the footsteps, like the show where the dude was patrolling. Do we leave footsteps? We do not. Kind of a good tell, though. Oh, they're not persistent either. Nice. We are entering the Matrix. Give it time with how VR is going. 10 years from now, you're gonna be having people hook their brains up and never coming back. Dark times. Okay, it's a collapsed stairwell. So what am I looking for? Just infiltrating the shaft trailer. All right.
Who's there?
Uh-oh. Somebody hurt me. Where is he? And now he won't hear anything ever again. Just eat both. I wonder what would happen if you did that. Like, what happens in the Matrix if you take both pills? You have one hell of a trip or something. Feels like it should be something. Off-kilter paintings. See, body armor that I actually don't want. I mean, I'm gonna take it because otherwise I'm gonna forget it's here, but alright. Electricity! The devil's tool. It's like Dungeons and Dragons. Dungeons and Dragons. Satan's game. Okay, I feel like we're probably supposed to maybe do something here. But the fucking camera is trying to murder me. I can't use this. Can I shoot it? I'm gonna shoot it with something that's not valuable to me. No. No more for me to grapple with my belt. All right. Well, it turns out you're just chewing on some guy's coat. Aww. Yeah, and this just loops around. Is there something up here that I missed, maybe? Aww. Okay, there's a power box over there. Can I, like... Where's my grenade launcher? That is not my grenade launcher. That is my grenade launcher. No. Can we get up here? Getting stuck on some form of terrain. No. Fucking camera. I'm never not gonna bitch about that. Can I? He's a slightly worn kilt. I'm not gonna ask questions. Try grenade jumping up there? I don't know. I imagine it's not gonna work, but you make a fair point. Nope. Grenade jumping. Grenades do not move you anywhere except to the floor. Alas. Had to try it. Good suggestion. Good suggestion. If I had to guess, I'm probably missing something obvious. I like to do that. This is where we find out that we were supposed to wait for the technician to fix the fuse box. But since he didn't, we've soft locked ourselves in the level. Let's see what's up here. That's right, this is snowed in. Can I... Can I... Oh! Oh, man! I don't know about you guys, but I'm good at video games. Let's see, travel the world, top-notch security organization seeks motivated individuals for managerial positions. Stock options and 401k available. Call today. There's no way that jumping on that little pole was like the intended way to get up here, but I'm telling myself that was the intended way to get up here, and I'm just really fucking good like that. Alright, so I assume that thing's working now. Can I do it again? I mean, I could, but I can't reveal my secrets to randoms on the internet, Celt. I'm sorry. Here. Oh no, I fell. Darn. Whatever will we do? I'm gonna have to meander my happy ass back up here. I'm curious what the actual intended way to get up there is. Okay, there's a window over there. So that's probably where you're intended to come from. Because, I mean, like, this is very obvious pathway here. But instead, I went the cool kids route and... threw myself off the ledge. I'm fucking amazing at video games. I just have to pretend I'm not. But yeah, I did that. It was pretty good. The cool kids are out. Yeah, you know, because it's got snow. Fucking camera. I don't know why it's being all jittery tonight. Normally it's been pretty good. That right there, that was the camera. It, like, just snapped out. This is my wife's curse is coming back to haunt me. All right, so let's see if I can do this again without fucking killing myself. It's actually not hard to do at all. You just gotta angle yourself right so that you don't get caught between this ledge right here like I just did. There we go. Let's kinda get up there. Oh my god. Movement engine stop. There we go. Yeah. And then you're in. Like, yeah. It's pretty straightforward. Yeah, I'm sure that's something speedrunners would do. Just completely ignore the mechanics. Or they'd go through the level the right way. I don't know. Maybe that's just me. Close it. And do that. Okay. So where are we going? That's back down. So I guess we have to just, go back down and take the elevator. I thought the elevator was going to go up, but apparently it goes down. All right. Why not? It does go up. The fiends! I was betrayed. Oh, that creaking makes me worry. This reminds me of something out of Thief right here when you're in the mines. Let's go ahead and prepare for maximum stealth. Yeah, this is like some fucking Hammerite temple shit right here. We're gonna go fight Illidan or something on top of this place. Seriously, game. This is when they finally introduce the aliens. There you go. Who just is gonna leave books in a little alcove like this? That's how you get mold. Ugh. Such gross mistreatment of probable historical treatises on, like, cattle management and wrangling. Don't joke, Selt. Oh! The Scotsman and Colonel Sanders!
Maybe we should throw her off a cliff.
Did I ask for your opinion?
No, but I was just thinking.
Oh, you were you?
Yes, I think keeping her alive is a bad idea.
Is that so?
You know how in spy shows the hero always gets away? Well, that just sets a considerable precedent, don't you think? Sure, it's just television shows, but it still makes me nervous.
Take a look at her!
Excuse me?
I said look at her! You want to murder her?
I don't want to, it just seems prudent.
Prudent, eh?
If you don't mind my saying so, you seem rather moralistic for a man who earns his living as a criminal. We've already killed thousands of people. What's one more?
It wasn't me that killed them.
You work for the organization that did. Doesn't that implicate you as well?
They didn't ask me what I thought about it.
Perhaps not, but you knew there was a possibility that such things could happen.
Okay, maybe you're right. But that doesn't mean I want this girl's blood on my hands. Truth be told, I'd sooner kill you than her.
Then I'll stop trying to convince you to throw her off the cliff.
That's prudent of you.
I must confess, I haven't been able to sleep since that explosion in England.
Me neither, lad.
Can I ask you a question? What would you do if I began walking towards a gondola dock with the intention of leaving this organization?
I might give you a piece of advice.
What would that be?
Don't get yourself killed.
The thought had occurred to me.
And now they're giving us like an Unreal Tournament flyby of the level. We wake up 30 years in the future.
I don't want any interruptions.
Yes, ma'am.
Wake up, princess. So, this is the indomitable Cate Archer, super spy.
Super spy.
Rough with you, dear. I'm not sure whether it's his Scottish blood or his peasant heritage, but he's rather lacking in social polish. Oh, but you're Scottish too, aren't you? Ah, how insensitive of you.
Baroness Dumont, you're not what I expected.
Is that so? Sorry if I'm a disappointment.
Not at all. Quite the opposite, in fact. Meeting your husband didn't lead me to expect much of the woman who'd choose to marry him.
Oh, yes, my husband. He's a child in the body of a man. A rather large man. All I have to do is play mommy every once in a while, and I get to spend his money any way I please. And he has plenty of money to spend. But enough about my vocation. Let's talk about yours.
Your vocation? But I thought you were working for Harm.
Harm works for me, darling.
I'm impressed. Not bad for a little orphan girl who went from princess to pauper. It takes a great deal of conviction to overcome adversity the way you have, or a great deal of hatred.
A little of both, actually. I wouldn't have expected such insight from someone like you.
Well, perhaps you don't know as much about me as you think.
I know enough. A girl spy in a man's world? That takes gall, surely. That you've been such a damnable nuisance speaks highly of your talents. But the fact that you're my prisoner suggests that you overestimate yourself. Just a bit. Little girl who thinks she can take on the world.
Is that so different from a little girl that thinks she can take over the world?
Well, we're both ambitious.
Too bad your ambition is so petty.
Is that what you think?
You might have done great things. Instead, look what you've settled for. Exacting revenge on people who remind you of those snobs that ostracized you and your mom after that nasty business with your father.
You call it revenge? I call it house cleaning.
House cleaning?
That's right. Every one of these smug blue bloods I scrub out makes the world a little cleaner. As far as I'm concerned, they're lint.
Excuse me, Baroness.
I said no interruptions! Somebody shoot this man! Where were we? Ah, yes. You were moralizing. Next, I suppose you'll tell me that I can't possibly succeed.
Not if I have anything to do with it.
You certainly have spirit. Unfortunately, you won't have anything to do with it. Not unless you can rise from the grave, that is. Are you afraid to die?
I haven't given it much thought.
Thanks to the incompetence of the insufferable Inga Wagner, you still have some time for reflection. My instructions were to give you a 10-hour fuse. But that bloated moron gave you 10 days, which leaves you roughly 45 minutes to live.
I've been infected. At the club. That dart that hit my neck.
Yes. And if it weren't for Fräulein Wagner's mind-numbing ineptitude, you'd already be dead.
You get what you pay for.
Isn't that the truth? You have no idea how hard it is to find qualified criminals these days. Nothing but misfits, mutants.
I hope you don't expect sympathy.
Not from a judgmental goody-two-shoes like you. To you, I'm just a villain. Those pretty eyes of yours see only black and white. Well, sister, the world is a crueler mistress than I. Believe me, I would have gladly kept my dollhouses and fairy tales rather than suffering through what I did. But I didn't have a choice in the matter.
You had a choice. You were just too weak to make the right one.
You don't know anything about me, girl. You don't know what I went through. Those genteel bastards disowned my mother and me before the headlines even hit the papers. Now I'm going to show my gratitude by raining fire and destruction down upon their pedigree heads.
Poor Felicity. The world spat upon her, so now she's going to show them all. Is that it?
I didn't give you permission to use my Christian name.
We've more in common than I like to admit. The difference is that I stopped taking my misfortunes personally. Everybody suffers, Baroness, but only cowards take it out on other people.
Lord, you're a righteous little bitch.
Oh!
Into heaven. I suppose you'll find...
There's that T rating.
Get Armstrong up here. I want someone competent guarding this door.
That's not a very nice thing to say.
Is that so? Well, after you fetch him, how would you like to take yourself outside and have yourself shot? That'll give you something to complain about.
Looks like you got yourself in a heap of trouble this time, eh, lass?
How about a fight?
What are you yapping about?
A fight. You and me. Mano a mano.
You're challenging me to a fight?
If I win, you let me go.
And if I win?
I'm already at your mercy. Are you a sportsman or a bully?
As entertaining as it sounds, I'm not about to stake my reputation as a master criminal on a dare from a wee little girl.
Coward.
Are you trying to provoke me?
Oh.
You're just afraid I'd clobber you.
Ha! I'd be more afraid of an angry chipmunk.
I always figured you for a sissy.
I dare you to say that again.
These are both really good.
I hear you had a torrid love affair with Inga Wagner.
Ha! In her fantasies, maybe.
You hit like a girl anyway.
If you're not careful, I'll fold you across my knee and thrash you till you shriek.
Now we're getting kinky.
Oh, that's right. I forgot you don't like girls.
Say that again and I'll wash your mouth out with soap.
Have you always been a coward, or is it a recent development?
Don't provoke me, missy. That's it! You pushed me too far, girlie!